Hello, 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 bam, fam. It is September 17th, 2020, and here's what you missed. Today's question of the day was, what makes a quality research question? Of course, it wouldn't be a grade 7 science lesson if I didn't ask for your insight first. We were introduced to the good question checklist. A good question is one that is testable, specific, kind, and relevant. Hashtag TSKR. In order to ensure we understood all four of those domains, I asked you to listen to a series of questions. And by listen, I mean we really listened to some. And using our TSKR list, we evaluated each question. Question number one came to us from the late, great Whitney Houston. You all weighed in with some really meaningful comments, and we concluded that though it might be a relevant question to Ms. Whitney, it might not necessarily be testable all across the board. What is love anyway? Question number two came to us from Lil' Kim. When y'all weighed in, you determined by an overwhelming majority that, despite its silliness, this is, in fact, a TSKR-certified scientific question. Our last question came to us from the world of TikTok, and it was,
who in the hell put the muffins in the freezer?
I did.
There was much debate about this question, but ultimately, it was determined that it doesn't really matter who put the muffins in the freezer. It just matters that they're in there. So we kind of ruled this one out in terms of relevance. Then I posed some questions of my own. I asked you, how many pounds of pressure can a human head withstand before it explodes? A lot of y'all were really troubled by the fact that I asked that. Why did I ask it? Because I wanted to have the conversation with you around kindness and ethics. When we do an experiment, we want to make sure that we're not making the world a worse place and we're not hurting people in the process, but that our understandings will lead to a better world. Now, some of you reflected on whether or not we could ethically test this theory, and one of you, hashtag Michael, dropped the knowledge that we could actually use skulls of the deceased individual. Good thinking, Michael. A final question that was posed was, who has the smelliest armpits on the planet? By an overwhelming majority, it was determined that this is not really the greatest of scientific questions because it's not exactly testable. We can't put 14 billion armpits in the same place at the same time and have the same nose smell all the armpits. It's not really testable. Then, you took a stab at posing some scientific questions and the class evaluated your post. Then I informed you that we are collectively going to develop a research question as a group, and that research question is going to be put towards an experiment that the class is going to design. Because of our virtual situation, of course, I am going to have to perform this experiment in the comfort of my own home for your enjoyment. I gave you the list of things that I have in my availability for you to work with, and then I turned you loose on developing what kind of scientific question you would like to eventually put to the test, trusting that you aren't going to kill me. In order to do that, of course, we talked briefly about the peer review process and how important it is to be open towards feedback from our peers and respectful towards receiving and giving feedback. Just like in real life, when scientists are starting to conduct experiments and seeking to put knowledge out in the world, they must confer with a series of peers under a revision process to make sure that what goes out to the general public is accurate, ethical, and all of those other good things. We talked about how the peer review process in science parallels the artist process. Most namely, we talked about the need to be respectful and cordial when we're engaging with each other, especially on the virtual landscape. Then, you guys got to work. You put your questions out on the board. We evaluated those questions by opinion and by the TSKR checklist. And then it came down to this. 8 a.m. decided that their research question shall be, how long does it take to cook an egg over an open flame? 10 a.m. came down to, how do we drop an egg without breaking it? And then we revisited the question of the day at the end of the class to find out for certain what makes a quality research question. And that's what you missed.